A very good day to all of you.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
You will be learning something new in today's class. But we will first revise what we learned in the previous class. Can you tell why we use the row option of the format menu? With the help of the row option of the format menu, you can hide or show any row, and you can also increase or decrease the size of the row. Can you tell why we use the print range? With the help of print range, you can define the data that you want to print by applying the print range on it. Can you tell why we use the column option of the format menu? With the column option of the format menu, you can hide or show your column or even increase or decrease its size. Can you tell why is auto format option used? With auto format, you can apply a predefined style on your table or sheet. These table designs are available for your use within auto format itself. Can you tell why conditional formatting is used? Using conditional formatting, you can apply any conditions on your data as desired and change its format accordingly. Do you know why we use the sheet option of the format menu? You can change the name of your sheet by using the sheet option of the format menu and can also hide or show the sheet. You need to remember that with the help of the insert menu options like cell, row, column or sheet, you can insert each of these in your table. This means that you can bring up cells, rows, columns or sheets. And with the help of the format menu options of cell, row, column and sheet, you can hide or show them and can also increase or decrease their size. All of you, switch on your computers and learn a new method to open your CalC file. With the help of this video, let us now learn a quick shortcut method of opening the CalC file. For opening the file, look for the Windows button and press it with one finger of your left hand. While keeping the Windows button pressed on the keyboard, look for the R button and press the R button once. As you can see in the video, a box opens, which is the Run Program box. And here, if you see something which is already written in the open text area, you can just press backspace, as we are doing in the video, and then type scalc or scalc, and then bring the pointer to OK and left click on it, or you can also press the enter button. As soon as you do this, you will see the open office opens and the CalC sheet, the spreadsheet opens for you. This way you can use the shortcut command to open the CalC file. Let us now see what you will learn today. In today's class, you will make a new table. Then you will be learning about some more formulas like odd, is odd, even, is even, fact, mod, pi, power, round, square root or SQRT and count A. All of you make the table being shown to you or open your old sheet. Let's first learn about the odd formula. Can you tell why is the odd formula used? Within a spreadsheet, you can check any value using the odd formula to see if it is an odd value or not. If that value is not odd, then this formula will show you the next odd value. With the help of the video, let us see the usage of odd and is odd formula. With the help of this video, let us now learn the usage of the odd and is odd formula. The odd formula will check the value, and if it is not odd, it adds 1 to it and then shows it as the next odd number. For instance, if we want to do the odd check odd formula in F2 cell, we are typing equal to odd, then start the bracket and then select the number that you want to check. So we select E2, which is 280, which is actually not odd. So when we close the bracket and then press enter, it adds 1 to the 280 number and shows it as 281. Again, in the next cell, let's do it one more time, equal to, then the odd formula is ODD, select the number. So this time we are selecting, or we can write a number, so we are writing 4, 4 is not odd, so it adds, as soon as you close the bracket and press enter, it adds 1 and shows you the next odd number. After 4, the next odd number is 5, so it shows you 5. Again, we are typing equal to odd, and we have typed 1 in the brackets this time. 1 is odd, so when we press enter, it shows you 1 as 1 itself. There's no change. If the number is odd, it remains odd. If it is not odd, 1 gets added and the next odd number is shown by the odd formula. Now let us see with the help of this video how we use is odd. So we are typing in the title first row in H column is odd. So we are going to use is odd here. So we have to type the formula, begin by equal to is odd, ISODD, begin bracket, which is shift and 9 key, and then select the value. So we are selecting 281. Is odd checks whether the number is odd or not and says true or false. So after selecting the number, closing the bracket, press enter, it shows you true because 281 is odd. Again in the next cell, equal to is odd bracket, select the value, which is 5. It's also odd. Close the bracket and press enter. Again it will show true because 5 is also odd. Let's practice it one more time. Is odd, and this time this number we are selecting is 1. As you know, 1 is also odd, so when you close the bracket and press enter, it also says true. Next, one more time we are doing equal to is odd, and this time let's select a even number. So we begin the bracket and we are selecting 280, which is even. Close the bracket, press enter, and it will say false because 280 is not an odd number. So this is how you can use odd to show you the next odd number and is odd to check if the number is odd or not. Let us now learn about the even formula. With the even formula, you can check any value and see if it is even or not. If it is not an even value, then this formula shows you the next even value. With the help of this video, let us learn more about even and is even formula. With this video, we are going to learn the usage of even and is even. With the formula for even, you can see if the number is even or not. If it is not even, it will add one and make it even. So you are typing the title as even in the first row in the G column. And to check here the formula, the usage is we have to type equal to, then type even, EVEN, begin bracket, and then select the number that you want to check. If it is even, it will remain even. If it is odd, it will add one and make it even and will show the next even number. So we select the number, close the bracket and press enter. Since number was 281, it adds one, makes it even and shows you the number 282, the next even number. Again, type equal to even, begin bracket, select the number. So we are selecting 5. Close the bracket, press enter. Again, 5 is odd, so it will add 1 and make it 6. Let's practice this once more time. Equal to even, begin bracket, and then select the number. So this time we are typing 2, and it's already an even number. Close the bracket, so there is no change. It will show you as 2. So this way, if you can check for any number, if it's an odd number, the formula adds 1 and shows you the next even number. Now let's see how we use the isEven. isEven formula checks whether a number is even or not and gives you an answer. If it is even, it will show true. If it is not even, it will show false. So in the J column, first row, we are writing is even because this is where we are going to use is even. And in the next cell, we are typing the formula, which is equal to, remember to put the equal to sign, equal to is even, isEven, begin bracket, and then select the value. So we are selecting 282, close the bracket, press enter. Because it's already even, it will show you true. One more time, let's select or use the formula for is even. Equal to is even, then bracket begin by shift and 9. Then select the number, which is 6 this time. Again, it is even, so it should show true. And we close the bracket, enter, and it shows true, as is being shown in the video. One more time, let's practice this. Type equal to is even, bracket begin by shift and 9. Select the number, this time let's select 5. 5 is odd. Close the bracket with shift and 0 and press enter. Since it is odd, it will say false. So this is how you can use the even formula, which will check if the number is odd, it will add 1 to it and show you the even number. And you can also use the isEven formula. So we are practicing it one more time. isEven, and then begin the bracket. This time we have selected 1. Since it's odd, close the bracket and it will show you false because it's not an even number. So this is how you can use the isEven formula to check if the number that you are using is even or not. And it shows you if it is even, it shows true. If it is not even, it shows you false. You will now learn about the fact formula. With the help of the fact formula, you can get the factorial of any value. You must be wondering, what is factorial? Factorial is the product of numbers of a value. For example, the factorial for 4 will be 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1, or 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Watch the video to learn more about using the fact or the factorial formula. In this video, we are going to learn to use the fact or the factorial formula. Factorial means for any number, you divide the, you multiply that number with all the numbers below it. So we first are selecting the H column for the factorial. So in the first row, we have written fact, F-A-C-T. Now to apply the formula, we have to type equal to, then F-A-C-T, fact, factorial, and then begin bracket, and then we have to type the number that we want to find the factorial of, or select the number. So we type 1 and close the bracket. Since 1 has only 1 in it, so 1 multiplied by 1, the answer is 1. So that's why the factorial of 1 will be 1 only. Let's see the factorial of 2 next. So we type equal to FACT fact or factorial and then begin bracket and then type 2, close the bracket, press enter. So 2 is made up of 2 and 1. So the factorial of 2 is 2 into 1. So it remains 2 because 2 into 1 is 2. Let's continue to practice the fact formula. So we are in the next column, we are just showing you how the factorial has been found, 2 into 1, which is 2. In the next cell, let's type equal to fact, F-A-C-T for factorial and bracket, and this time let's select or type the number 3, close the bracket, press enter. So the factorial for 3 will be 3, and then the numbers which are 3 is made up of is 3, 2 and 1. So 3 into 2 into 1, as is being shown here in the I column for you. 3 into 2 into 1. So if you multiply these, you know that the answer is 6. So factorial for 3 would be 6. Once again, let's practice the factorial for and find the factorial for. Let's just increase this column size a little bit. In the H column, now we are typing fact equal to fact. And this time, let's find the factorial for 4. The next number is 4. Close the bracket. Press enter. And the factorial for 4, which is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So you can see the factorial for 4 is 24. Factorial for 4 is 24. In the next column, we are just showing you how the factorial has been found. So it's a product of 4, 3, 2 and 1. So 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. In the next cell, we are finding the factorial for 5. So we write equal to fact, begin bracket, type the number 5, close the bracket and press enter. And the answer is 120. So you can see the factorial 5 is made by 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which comes, the answer comes 120. Let's practice this one more time. Now we are going to get the factorial for 6. So the factorial for 6, we again type equal to FACT, begin bracket 6, close bracket, press enter, and you can see 720 is the answer. We can see in this column how it is done. 6, for factorial 6, the factorial would be 6 multiplied by all the numbers which are below it. So 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Let's also just double check this. So to check, You can use the formula for multiplication, and we can use the formula for multiplication by equal to product, or we can use the symbol, which is the star symbol. So equal to 2 into 1, the answer is 2. In the next one, we type equal to 3 into 2 into 1. And the answer, when we press enter, is 6. So similarly, you can check the factorials that we have found for the other numbers. The next one is factorial for 4. So we type equal to 4 star 3 or into 3 star 2 star 1. 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1, and then we press enter, the answer is 24. In the next one, we are checking, you can see the answers which we have found were the same earlier also, 24, and there also we have found 24. So for factorial 5, it was 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So we have to type equal to 5 star 4 star 3 star 2 star 1, press enter, and the answer is correct, which is 120. For factorial of 6, we are typing equal to then 6 star 5 star 4 star 3 star 2 star 1, press enter, and we get the factorial. Answer is 720, which is the correct answer. Next, we learn about the mod formula. By using the mod formula, you can come to know whether a given number will get fully divided by another given number or not. Watch the video and learn more about this. Now, with the help of this video, let us practice the use of the mod formula. In the mod formula, you divide a number by any other number and see if it is totally divided or not. If it is not totally divided, then the remainder will be shown. If it is totally divided, 0 will be shown. So we have typed MOD in the E column here in the 11th row, because we want to practice the use of mod. And below that, in the next cell, we have to type the mod formula. So we have to type equal to, and for mod MOD, begin bracket, and then first you have to type the dividend or the first number that you want to divide. So let's type 8, and then you have to put a semicolon and then put the divisor or the number with which you want to divide the dividend or the 8 number. So we put a semicolon and then we put the divisor as 4. So we are dividing 8 by 4, and you know it gets completely division, there is no remainder. So when we close the bracket and press enter, the mod formula shows the answer as 0. There is no remainder. One more time, let's practice the use of mod. Equal to MOD, begin bracket by using shift and 9 key. And then let's type a number here. This time let's type the dividend as number 9. So we need to divide 9, and now we need to type the number which is the divisor with which we want to divide 9. So we type semicolon and then we have typed 4. So now you know if you divide 9 by 4, there will be a remainder which is 1. So when we close the bracket and press enter, mod will show the remainder as 1. One more time, let's practice mod. We type equal to MOD, begin bracket. This time let's select the dividend or the number that we want to divide as 20, semicolon, and let's divide this by 7, or the divisor is 7. So if you divide 20 by 7, there will be a remainder of 6. So when we type 7 and close the bracket and press enter, you will see that the mod formula will show you an answer of 6 as the remainder. Can you tell what is the value of pi? The value of pi is fixed and it is 22 divided by 7, or we can say 22 by 7 or 3.14. With the help of the video, let us see how we use the pi formula. Let us see in this video how we can get the value of pi on our calci sheet. So let's first type the title pi, where we want to introduce the pi value in our sheet. So we have typed pi here as is being shown in the video, and the formula for getting the pi value is very simple. We have to type equal to, then we have to type pi, pi, and then begin bracket and close bracket. Remember, you don't have to type any value or number within the bracket. Just press enter and the pi value will come on this cell where you have asked for the pi value. So the pi value is shown 3.14159, or simply we can say it is 3.14. Let's try once more. We type equal to pi. And then let's see what happens if we type a number within the bracket. It will show an error. So we have typed 2, close bracket, enter, and shows an error. So this way you can get the value of pi where you want by using the formula equal to pi, bracket begin, bracket close. Let us now learn about the power formula. Using the power formula, you can arrive at the power value of any given number. So, if you are given the value 2 with a power of 2, it means that you have to multiply 2 by 2 to get the power value. Let us watch the video and learn how we use the power formula. Let us now learn about the usage of the power formula. Power shows how many number of times we have to multiply the number with itself. So let's type power in the column G where we want to use the power formula. And in the next cell, to type the power formula, as you all know, we first have to type equal to, and then for power, you have to type the word power, P-O-W-E-R, P-O-W-E-R. So it is being shown in the video to you. Open the bracket with shift and 9, and then you have to type a number which is called the base number, then put a semicolon and then type the power, how many times you want to multiply this base number with itself. So we are typing 2 and we are typing a semicolon, and then we are typing the power. The power also we are saying 2. So what effectively this means is 2 has to be multiplied by itself 2 times, 2 into 2. The answer obviously is 4. We can also see this, check the correctness of the answer with the product formula or with the multiply symbol, which is star. So we type equal to 2 star 2 or 2 into 2, press enter, and the answer, as you know, is 4. Let's practice this once more. Equal to power, bracket begin, and the base number, which this time is 4. Then we put a semicolon and then we type the power, that is how many times we want to multiply 4 by itself. So we are saying 3, which means the base number is 4, power is 3, 4 into 4 into 4. Close the bracket, press enter, and you get the answer as 64. You can check this also again, equal to 4 into 4 into 4. So 4 into itself 3 times, 4, 4, 4, multiplied. 4 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 4, press enter, and you get the answer 64. So our power formula is doing its correct job. Let's practice one more. Equal to power, P-O-W-E-R. And this time, let's take the base number as 5. So bracket, begin bracket, then type the base number 5. Then put the semicolon and then put the power number. So we are using 5 as power number also, which means we are multiplying 5 by itself 5 times. So 5 into 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. Close the bracket, press enter, and you can see the answer, which is 3125. 3125. So this is how powerful this power formula is. You can once again check whether this is the correct answer. So we can type the multiplication formula here. Simple multiplication formula equal to 5 star 5 star 5 star 5 star 5. So 5 multiplied by 5, 5 times. And when you press enter, you can see that this also gives you the same result, which is 3125. 3125. Let's practice it one more time. Equal to power, P-O-W-E-R. Bracket, begin bracket. And let's take the base number this time. We are taking it as 2. But this time, instead of, let's take a different power. So we have taken 2 to the power 6. We can also, when we write the number, we can also say 2 to the power 6. When you close the bracket and press enter, the answer 64 appears. So you can check this also. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So 2 multiplied by 2, 6 times, as is being shown in the video to you, and then press enter. You can see 64 is the answer. So this is how you can use the power formula to get the power of any base and power. Come, let's learn now about the round formula. The round formula helps you to round off the value after the decimal such that if that value is more than 5, then 1 gets added to the previous numeral. Watch the video and learn the usage of round formula. With the help of this video, let us now see how the round formula is used. Let's first type round here, as is being shown in the video, because below this cell will be, first we are typing the numbers that we want to round off. So we have typed numbers, and then in the next cells we have typed some numbers here in decimals. So the first number is 2.2345. The next one is 4.6759, and the next one is 0.876. Note that we are typing all of them in decimals. The last one is 5.4567. Now, in this column E, we are going to apply the round formula. So we have typed round as the title, and to apply the formula, type equal to then you have to type round, R-O-U-N-D, open the bracket with shift and 9, and then you have to have the number which you want to round off. So let's select the number 2.2345, then put a semicolon, and then put a count. The count means after the decimal, how many numbers do you want? That is the count. So if we say 2, we want 2 digits after the decimal. Close the bracket and then press enter. So you will see that for 2.2345, if we are rounding off after the second decimal place, it becomes 2.23. Let's take another example. For the next number, we are typing equal to round, and then we have selected the number 4.6759, and this time we have kept the count as 3, which means after the decimal we want 3 digits. So close the bracket and press enter, and this time it returns 4.6759. Remember that since we wanted 3 digits, and since the fourth digit 9 was greater than 5, so it made the 4.675 as 4.676. It added 1 to the digit below the 9, before the 9. Again, one more example. We are saying equal to round, and then we have selected 0.876, and we are saying 1 place after the decimal, so 1 count. So instead of 0.8, because the next digit is 7, so that got rounded off and it became 0.9. For the last number, we are typing equal to round, select the number 5.4567, and then the decimal place, the count we are giving as 1. Only one number we want after the decimal. So, see, you can notice that it was 5.4567, where 5 is equal to or greater than 5. So, instead of 5.4, it has become 5.5. This is how you can use the round off formula on your Calci sheet. Next, learn about the usage of the SQRT or square root formula. With square root, you can find the square root value for any given number. With the help of the video, see how the SQRT or square root formula is used. In this video, we are now learning how we can use the square root formula. The square root formula will give you the square root of any number, and the formula uses SQRT for square root. So we just type square root in the cell as a title, SQRE root root, and then for the formula we use equal to, and for the square root formula you just have to type SQRT. So we type equal to SQRT, begin bracket, and then type the number for which you want the square root. So we have typed 25, close the bracket, press enter, and the answer you get is 5. As you know, square root for 25 is 5. Or in other words, 5 multiplied by 5 is 25. In the next cell, we are once again using the formula for square root, equal to square root. Then begin bracket with shift and 9 key, and then we have typed 49, close bracket, press enter. 49 is the square of 7, or in the next cell we are typing SQRT, bracket, and this time we have chosen the number 100 within the bracket. As soon as you press enter after closing the bracket, 10 is the answer. So the square root for 100 is 10. one more time, equal to sqrt begin bracket with shift and 9 key, and this time we have typed 200. So if we type 200, close the bracket, press enter, you can see that the square root is automatically obtained here, which is 14.14213635.62. So that's the square root for 200. If you multiply this number by itself, you will get 200. This is how you use the square root formula. Let us now learn about average and average A formula. With the average formula, you can derive the average of a group of numbers. Do you know how we derive the average? When you have to get the average of a set of numbers, you need to first add up all the numbers and also count how many numbers are there. Then, to get the average, you divide the total by the count of the numbers. Watch the video and learn more about using the formula for average. With the help of this video, we are now going to learn how we use the average formula. So, if you want to get the average of the marks that a student has scored, as is shown in this spreadsheet, we are choosing the F column for the average. So in the first row, we are writing the title, average, AVERAGE. In the next column, let's type the formula, equal to, then you have to type the word average, AVERAGE, begin bracket with shift and 9 key, and then you have to type the numbers separated by semicolon or select the numbers. So since we are wanting the average of these three marks of English, Hindi and Maths, we select these three for the A row or for the A student, and then close the bracket and then press enter. So you will get the average marks for student A, which is shown here, 93.3333. If you want to check if we have got the correct average, or if you want to get the average in the normal method by adding the total marks and dividing by the number of subjects, we can do that also. So we type equal to, then we type the total marks, which is 280. So we can either select that or we can type that here, and then divided by, we use the slash for divided by, and because there are three subjects, so we divide this by three. Press enter and you will get the same answer, 93.333. So this way you can average using the formula and in the normal method. Now you can drag down this formula for all the other rows and you will get the average marks for all the students A to E. This is how you will be using average on your Calci sheet. Let us now learn about the average A formula. You can use the average A formula to find the average for any text and numbers both together. Learn from the video about the usage of the average A formula. With this next video, we are going to learn the use of the average A formula. With average, you were able to take the average of numbers only, whereas with average A, you can get the average of both numbers and text. So we are typing in the G1 row or the G1 cell, average A as the title. Now to apply the formula, we have to type equal to and then the word average A. AVERAGEA, average A, and then begin bracket, shift and 9, and you can see it says value 1, value 2, which means that you can have the value which can be a text or a number. If you remember, if we only type equal to average ABERAGE and then begin bracket, you can see it says numbers. So for the average formula, you will be only able to get the average of numbers. But if you are using average A, as we are going to see in the video again, average A and then begin the bracket, it says give the value 1, value 2. So we'll pick the value. First value we are picking is A. So it uses the value, if it's a text value, it gives it a value of 1 and then gets an average after adding that 1 with the other numbers. Then you have to separate it with semicolon, select the next value, which we are taking as the English marks for student A. Again, put a semicolon, select the next value, which is 97 for Hindi. Again, we are taking semicolon and the number 98 for maths for student A. Close the bracket and then press enter. So it brings the average of A. It assumes A to be 1 and then adds it to 85, 97, 98 and then divides it by 4. And that way we get the average as 70. Similarly, for the next student B, let's do this once again, equal to average A, we type average A and then begin bracket. Then we have to take from value 1 to the as many values as we want. So we can just select all the values together if they are like this. B, 98, 98 and 45. We have selected it together. Close the bracket and then press enter. So you will get the average for this, which this time is 60.25. Here again, the value of B has been taken as 1. So 1 and is added to 98 plus 98 plus 45 divided by 4. For the others, you can just drag the formula which you had just applied down and you can get the average A for all of these students. So this is how you will apply the average A formula on your CALCI sheet. Now learn about the COUNT A formula. Can you tell why is the COUNT formula used? The COUNT formula helps you to count the number of cells which have some value in the table that you have selected. This will give you the count of the cells that have some value in them. Can you tell why is the COUNT blank formula used? With the COUNT blank, you can get a count of the blank cells within the selected data or table. Do you know why is the count A formula used? With count A, you can get a count of the cells that have some value in the data or table that you have selected. Count A counts both numbers and text. Let us now watch this video and learn what happens when we use all these three formulas. Let us now see how we can use the COUNT A formula, which helps us to count all the values of the cells in which either there is text or a number. So first let's write COUNT A as a title. We are doing that in the H column. And then below that, in the next cell, we are typing the formula for COUNT A. COUNT A, C-O-U-N-T, A. And then we begin bracket, which is shift and 9 key. And then you can see value 1, value 2. So as value 1, we are first selecting these numbers or these cells from column D. And then we are putting a semicolon. And we can select similarly the next column also for the value, next value. So after the semicolon, we are selecting the numbers where it says round and there are numbers below that. So we select these we can close the bracket and then press enter and you get the answer as 10. This is because in these 5 and 5 cells that you had selected, the text and numbers, the total is 5 plus 5. So there are 10 values where, or 10 cells where some text or some numbers are appearing. So count A counts all of those cells. Let's do this once again. Equal to count A, begin bracket. And then now we are selecting all these marks of these students from A to E. And we close the bracket and then press enter. So you can see it gets an answer of 30, because all the 30 cells that we had selected, there is either a number or some text is written there. So this is how count A helps you to count the cells in the selected area where there is either a number or some text. Once again, we are typing count A, begin bracket, and this time we have selected empty cells. Let's see what happens. Let's close the bracket, press enter, and you will get 0, because when count A is trying to count the number of text or numbers in those cells, there were no numbers or text, so it says 0. Now, if you still have some time, you can go ahead and revise the formulas that you learned earlier. Since this class ends here, save your file and then properly shut down your computer. Let us take a look at what you have learned today. In today's class, you learned about some more formulas like odd, is odd, is even, fact or factorial, mod, pi, power, round, sqrt or square root, count A, average and average A.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
Thank you.